How is everybody doing today? Welcome back to the Elements walkthrough for Elementor. If you followed along, we've been covering the different elements inside of the Elementor WordPress page builder plugin. We've covered a few. Now it's time to cover the divider, which is the next element on the list, and we're actually going to be covering the divider and the spacer in the same video. It's because it's very close to the exact same thing. The only difference is the divider has a line and the spacer does not. So basically the divider is nothing but a line to divide two different sections. You see one here in the footer. There's a white line here directly across at the bottom. That is a divider, and then you get extra space and stuff is the spacer. So you can do solid. You can look at it and do double. Let's see here. I don't know why it didn't. There we go. There's dotted. And it's not doing double for some reason. And I don't know if it's something with my computer today or what. I normally don't do double, so I don't know if it's just trying to pick up on that. And I don't know. And then dashed is, you know, kind of dots with longer lines. But normally I'll use solid. You can change the width of it as far as how thick the line itself is. You can choose if you want it to go complete full width of the page. You can set it at like 50% and center it. You know, if you need to break it off that way, or if you have like a headline here and you just want to, you know, kind of have it halfway across and maybe line up even with the headline with a fancy little image to the right or something like that. You know, you can, you know, get totally creative with this and use many different things. The gap, which is basically the spacing between the line and the divider, it's the thickness of the divider on the top and the bottom of the line itself. So that gives you the extra spacing in between the element above it and the element below it. And then the next thing is advanced. Once again, advanced is the exact same settings in all of the elements. If you're interested in a more in-depth walkthrough on the advanced settings, you can go back to the Elementor sections video. And I might actually, because I'm really getting tired of saying it, I might actually go in and just do an advanced walkthrough, cover each of these individually. But if I do, it'll be after the rest of these like 80 something videos. So, but anyways, that is the divider. So I'm going to come in here just to show you the difference between the divider and the spacer. We're going to bring the spacer in, and you see it's basically nothing. Of course, advanced, same thing. But in the content section, the only thing you're doing is adding space, nothing else. So it's, you can add 600 extra pixels of empty space. So if you have like a background image and you need like a text at the top and a space in between like where someone's face is or something in the image, or maybe you have, you know, something you want to have that extra space, this is how you do it. And of course, having 600 blank pixels somewhere on your website doesn't really work unless you have a purpose for it. So just be mindful of how it will look and how it will, you know, flow as the visitors go through the website. But that's the basically the wrap up between the divider and the spacer. If you like the video, please be sure to like the video, come back and check in as we move forward with the tutorial going into Google Maps and icons to wrap up the basic Elementor elements. I've had fun doing this video with you guys. Hope you guys have enjoyed it. If you like the video, please like the video. Be sure to subscribe. After you subscribe, don't forget to click the bell so you can get a notification when I upload new content. That being said, be great, stay boosted, and we'll catch you guys in the next video. Take care.